Hi, welcome. It's me, Anne Marie, from the Bickerton Grace Gallery, and I'm here with Tamara.
Hi there.
Welcome. Tamara is here today because we have a solo exhibition of yours coming up at the end of September into October. So we're going to talk about that. But before we go into that, let's have a little bit of an insight into who Tamara is. So can you start by telling us, where did it all begin as an artist for you? When did you know that this was your calling?
As far as I remember, I always was drawing, painting, and being interested in visual, especially coming from the family that did art all over me, around me. And
so your family were very artistic?
Yes, my father is an amazing painter.
Wow.
But my auntie was the one to inspire me because she had this fantastic studio with figurative art, and I think it was a spark for
and
me.
Where was this?
It was in my town when I was born and raised, and where I finished Academy of Art, which is Sarajevo, which is former Yugoslavia, but now it's Bosnia.
Wow.
So yeah.
So then you moved here. So had you started doing art full-time while you were still there, or did that happen when you moved over?
Well, I just took my degree before I came here, which was 1992, and then I had to survive.
Yeah.
It was a really hard time, but for everybody else who came from war zone. But I was at first working in one gallery in Cork Street.
Okay.
Interesting. Mayor Gallery, which was great experience. But then slowly I set up myself to get back into working, which took some time because you need space. Although I never gave it up, even though the hardship of, you know,
survival.
Living in a very small room without window.
Yeah.
I was still painting in my bed.
Yeah.
The big paintings were inside of my bed, and I was just like painting until I had enough body of work to actually show it.
Can you remember your first exhibition?
Yes, it was, I can't remember the year, but it was like a few years after I made a certain amount of work.
That must be quite exciting.
And it was in the place of a friend who organized it, who had like a really nice open plan.
Yeah.
It wasn't gallery to begin with, but slowly, it took off, and it was very busy.
So your style, let's talk about that, because I mean, you do abstract, you do figurative. Is there one that you prefer more than the other, or is it just come in flows for you?
Well,
they work together,
I think they worked very much together.
Yeah.
And my dissertation was from figurative to abstract.
Yeah.
And I was always kind of, you know, floating between two. But predominantly, perhaps, I am a very figurative artist because, you know, my training was very classical. So we always had models, and I keep on using this until today. I have models every week that I work with and from that I develop big paintings afterwards. But I would say it's complements each other, the figurative and
abstract.
They
do. I mean, we can see that from the pieces that we've got, and even we've got here.
Yeah.
I mean, the two pieces behind us, we've got Blue Moon and Passion.
That's right, yeah.
And what's great having them together with the blues and the reds, I mean, they just fuse into each other in a space.
That's right.
Which is so beautiful. Tell us about Passion, because that one's got a bit of a story behind it, hasn't it?
Yes, Passion was one of the paintings that I didn't want to sell, ever. because it was an award-winning painting from London Biennale 2017.
Wow.
And it's a dear painting to me, and I think it's very special, but now it's here, so it's available.
So you go in. It's had quite a lot of feedback as well since it's been here. People that have walked
That's
in
really
and just
good.
Gone, wow, as they've seen it, because it is quite
That's
a
important.
Dramatic piece, isn't it?
It is.
So
quite.
I can see why you wanted to hold on to it for as long as possible. You have to let them go.
Yeah,
to go
sometimes.
Eventually. And then Blue Moon, is that more recent?
Blue Moon is also around, I would say a little bit more recent. It's to do with this phenomena of the moon. At one point, moon was I don't know why they call it blue moon, because it's not really blue, but it's just an idea of planets, you know, having an impact of us, especially me, because I'm a very atmospheric person. It does give, you know, something sfumato, as they would say in Italy, like, you know, something that is very magical. Yeah. And I thought it's a very beautiful painting to complement this passion one, because you can also see figures in there, should you wish, and it's open to interpretation for each individual.
So you've got quite a lot of hidden things within the images as well.
That's right.
The layers. And you work mainly with acrylics?
Acrylics and a lot of different mediums to create texture. And often these are acrylic mediums, but also sand and all sorts of organic stuff.
Yeah.
So it does help to build the layers and play with the texture.
Yeah. So what can we expect from the exhibition?
Well, it's very exciting, and I'm looking forward to it very much, because this will be, I imagine, one of the solo shows where I would be able for the first time to represent myself in a different way, in a retrospect, showing works from period of years.
Yeah, amazing.
So it's going to be a nice combination of drawings, prints, large-scale canvases, as well as maybe even reliefs. I have a lot in mind.
So
I think it's going to be very interesting.
Truly your story.
Truly massively. Story, yeah.
Yeah.
From so figurative to abstract.
Yeah, amazing. And it'll be wonderful to see it in this space.
This space is fantastic.
You'll be walking through, obviously, the different stages.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Different years. Yeah, that's right.
So we will give the dates and more information about that closer to the time, or from now. So we're talking end of September, so I'll give you exact dates when we discuss it. But yeah, lots to look forward to.
A lot, yeah.
Well, thank you for talking.
Thank you.
Because I know Tamara she doesn't want to be in front of the camera very much. So
this not at all.
So I'm so glad you did. And I think it's really lovely to see the artist behind these incredible creations. So follow us and, see when this exhibition's coming. Come along, and there might be some a nice little musical interlude as well.
Oh, yes.
So we'll keep you posted on that. We won't say much more about that just yet.
But, surprise.
Thank you. Yeah. And we will speak soon. All the best.
Thanks. Bye.